Batman. I was hoping to get a minute of your time. See, I've got a... Hello everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Batman Arkham Origins. Now, earlier today I was on PS4, but I got rather annoyed with one of my friends on there. I'm not going to name and shame him, but yeah, he just really annoyed me. As you all know, I've been unwell recently, and just all this week I've just had shit from people. You know, from former friends, not this one individual on PS4, but my so-called other friends that were meant to be my friends haven't bothered with me for quite a long time, and to be honest with you, I've now decided to not even bother trying, because when your friends don't even bother coming to see you for your birthday, you know, what does that tell you? Well, it tells me that I don't need that. So, yeah. So, I've come on PS4, everyone left that was in my party, so I've decided to do some more recording. And to be honest with you, I'm not really in the mood to play with people who just don't respect me. Had this on my channel sort of in the last sort of like few weeks. There was one sort of person who was writing on my channel, and he was being quite nice, perfectly civil, perfectly, you know, nothing bad or anything like that, and then he started being, you know, rather disrespectful. So I very very in my rights said that I won't tolerate any form of anyone who treats me with disrespect, who abuses me on my channel, and anyone who does that to my subscribers, to myself, or to anyone else who is in me with, if I stream, I've got people on the stream with me, so anyone who streams with me, plays with me, anyone who goes with me, who's on mic with me, anyone like that, anyone who is disrespectful in any shape or form, I will deal with you on the best of what I can do through YouTube. So that will be, your comments will be removed, you'll be reported to YouTube, and that'll be that, and you won't be allowed to comment on my videos. This is not a dig at anyone in particular. It's not me trying to sound like I'm gonna, you know, be an asshole or anything like that. I just don't like that this is done, and I can't be doing with it. It's not something I'm willing to accept, and that's all on it. I'm not going to talk about it anymore. But so let's continue the game. So I'm going to do this now for... I'm going to continue this. So let's continue the game. So I'm going to try and... I'm going to try now and just continue this game, do another few videos just to try and get this game moving along, because I do want to finish this before the end of January. So it's the 21st, so I've got tonight and tomorrow. So I'm going to probably record down to probably about midnight. I've got quite a lot of time. So I probably will do them for about, you know, half an hour, 45 minutes, something like that, to really get as much done as I possibly can. and I hope you like waking up with a headache.
If I can't tap into the cops' communications, I should hack their mobile relay station.
Rubio, what's your 20?
On the balcony for a smoke with a menace.
There's men on the balcony. That could be my way in.
Shut case. Penguin murdered Black Mask and his lady friend. I mean, we found the bastard's
stubby little fingerprints right by the bodies.
Yeah, we got Penguin now. Like to see him squirm out of this one. Fingerprints, two dead bodies.
You're just making...
All right.
Believe Penguin murdered Black Mask, but why would he send me here if he was the killer? It doesn't add up. This crime took place days ago. The fire and the exposure to the elements make identifying the victims difficult. The male victim is wearing a black mask, but I can't positively identify him as Roman Sionis without a DNA analysis, something I can't do in the field. Identify the female victim based on her fingerprints. Tiffany Ambrose, Roman Sionis' girlfriend. Or one of them, at least. She was no angel. Long list of priors. But nothing to indicate she was the target here. The fire spread as a result of a Molotov cocktail thrown into the room. It may have been intended to destroy evidence. Trajectory of the bullet suggests the shooter could be someone of Penguin's height. But the grooves on the floor suggest that the victim was killed by someone leaning back in a chair. This bullet was fired from a revolver. Ballistics analysis indicates a low angle of trajectory. The shooter could have been someone of Penguin's height. But the pattern in the gunpowder residue suggests the bullet was actually fired by someone lying on the ground. These fingerprints are a match for the Penguin, but they're on top of the soot from the fire. The cops were right. Penguin was in the room. But these prints prove he was here after the murders were committed. If he didn't kill Black Mask, who did? The only thing I know for certain is that Tiffany's shooter was lying on the floor. But why? These white streaks are shoe polish. Whoever shot Tiffany was being dragged along the floor. Besides the victims, there were two other people in the room. Tiffany's shooter, and whoever was dragging the shooter. The location from which the male victim was shot may tell me more. one impact area I haven't checked for clues. This DNA is from the female victim. The level of oxidation suggests it's been here for several days. If I review the evidence, I may be able to find out what she was doing when she was attacked. She was sending text messages to Roman Sionis about someone named the Joker. Someone killed Black Mask, but this crime took place several days ago. And I saw Black Mask earlier tonight. The only answers I have raise more questions. Who is the Joker? Was he the killer here? Or is he one of the assassins? I have a body, an unknown shooter, and an unknown assailant who attacked the shooter. I need to match the DNA samples against the records in the National Criminal Database to identify who was in the room. Alfred, I need access to the National Criminal Database.
Well, the only way to do that would be to infiltrate the Gotham City Police Department.
Then that's where I'm going.
Sir, you'd need to physically hack into their servers. If you insist on doing something that foolish, you'll need a powerful non-lethal weapon. I recommend coming back here to pick up your concussion detonator.
Not a bad idea.
All right, so we now know that someone, an assailant called the Joker, hint, was responsible for the crime here. And because the police have buggered off now and gone, we are now... Whoa! All right. Time to leave. So I'm well on the way now to actually getting this game sort of like back on track with the
Come in, 82. Dispatch, Delta 44. Can you raise Delta 82?
Stand by, 44. Delta 82. Delta 82, come in. Delta 82, come in. Delta 82, report. Delta 44, no response from 82. Please proceed inside to confirm 82's status.
10-4, dispatch.
Alright, time to go back to the Batcave.
Instead of your fists, you'll do less lasting damage to those police officers and civil servants.
Noted.
A new one that you don't get in the other games.
Sir, a moment of your time.
What do you want?
There's something about this Enigma fellow that doesn't sit right with me. Unfettered access to resources, an extensive network spread across the city. Whoever he is, the man has connections and capital.
We can use that to our advantage. If he's buying things in bulk or using lots of power, we could track him.
Perhaps, but he's also clearly a technical wizard. He's likely covered his tracks.
Keep searching. He only has to slip up once to give us an opening.
Certainly, sir. Sir, if I might.
What is it, Alfred?
You may wish to curb your, shall we say, evening dalliances.
Oh?
I wouldn't like you to develop a, well, a reputation, Master Bruce.
A little late for that.
Better later than never, no? Since when did masks aspiring crime lords.
We can't. Scratch that idea. I thought we could change bat suits, but we can't. I'm just going to go and grab something very quickly, so I'll be back in 2 seconds. Just going to go to the right place. Alright. Right, now we've got another phase up and running, we can now get out of here, well, we can now travel here whenever we want to.
Real trick.
No. I think not. First things first now is to go... Oh, we can destroy some of these. Let's destroy them, shall we? Excuse me. Oh, right, there's one over here apparently. Oh, hang on, it's right there. Come on! Let's go and collect the get these things before we do anything else. Sorry about that, knocking the mic. I don't know where to go for this bloody thing, you know? You know what? Whatever. I can't figure it out. Another data handler down. Where are we? Right, I think we'll now go and start. We'll move across to where we need to go. I can't get around the other side to get that. Right. We need to go this way. we'll go this one next. Right, okay. And the next one is right below me. I want to find these sucking things because I'll get experience for it, and if I do that then I'll be able to level up again. I don't think that one here is actually... is it on the roof? It's got to be underneath. Let's go have a look. Let's go and find out, shall we? Because I'm pretty close to leveling up and I do want to get this sort of done before we do anything else. And I think if we go underneath this, then we should be able to get it. But it's a question of where it is. Is there anywhere we can go down underneath? Yes, over here. Ah, can't get down there. Shit. Aha. Right, I'm not even near it now. It's underneath this thing. Right, I can't get... hang on. Like, I can't get it now, obviously. I can't get up there for some stupid reason. Right, okay. Well, let's go now to the police station, shall we? Oh my days. I'm now going completely the wrong direction. Right, let's go to the police station. You know what, guys? I think I'm going to call this a video, so thank you very much for watching. Next time we will enter the GCPD and find out if we can find out any more about this killer Joker and the identities of those guys back in the hotel. So until then, guys, thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time.